हरे कृष्णा। बेनिफिट्स एंड एडवांटेजेस ऑफ एसोसिएटिंग विद गुड पीपल स्पेशली द सेंटली पीपल इज ग्लोरिफाइड इन प्रैक्टिकली एवरीवेयर स्पेशली इन आवर स्क्रिप्चर्स ऑल्सो राइट। इवन श्री कृष्णा वेन ही वॉज स्टेइंग इन वृंदावन एंड अक्रूरा केम टू टेक हिम, कृष्णा स्टार्टेड ग्लोरिफाइंग अक्रूरा बिकॉज ही वॉज सेंटली पर्सन। कृष्णा सेज नायम मयानि तीर्थानि न देवे मृशिलामयम ते पुनंति उरिकालेन दर्शनात् एव साधवः। सो कृष्णा इज टेलिंग ऑफ कोर्स द होली प्लेसेस आर अडॉन विद द तीर्थ राइट द होली रिवर्स ऑल्सो दैट यू नो डेमिगॉड्स एक्चुअली डिसेंड इनटू देयर डीटी फॉर्म बट सोल गेट्स प्यूरिफाइड इन देयर एसोसिएशन आफ्टर अ लॉन्ग कोर्स ऑफ टाइम उरुकाले न। बट इफ अ पर्सन सीज अ डिवोटी अ साधवः अ डिवोटी ऑफ लॉर्ड श्री कृष्णा ही गेट्स इमीडिएटली बेनिफिटेड ही गेट्स इमीडिएटली प्यूरिफाइड। देर इज वन स्टोरी, वंस देर वॉज अ थीफ अ रॉबर and he used to do stealing by, you know, he used to do small stealings. But one day he decided that I will do a robbery, a bigger robbery, which will give me so much money that I will not need to work in the future anymore. So he was waiting for a better opportunity. So he waited. One day he thought, let's rob the king's palace. So he decided a particular time. On that day, king had called many sannyasis, many sadhus, many brahmacharis to his palace to have a discussion, right? So he thought, oh no, this is a better opportunity. So many people will be coming, and of course, king will give them the donation, and that will be the opportunity for me to steal the money from them. So he also joined the parties of the sannyasi. He also wear a saffron cloth and he went with them. And you know, now the sadhus were discussing and he was listening to all the discussion of the sadhus. They were talking about the Krishna, they were talking about the renunciation and the miseries of the material world, so many things, right? And here the king was making announcement. He told, my dear sadhus, my dear sannyasi, today I have called you because you know, my daughter is now, you know, she want to, you know, marry with some of you, one of you actually. So, you know, I'm looking for a better husband. If somebody comes forward and marries with my daughter, I will give the half of the kingdom to him. 50% of my kingdom will be his. So please come, you know, who wants to marry with my daughter? And in the first row of the sannyasi, they just got up and they said, what the hell this is? You know, we are the sannyasi, we are the renunciate, we are not supposed to marry with anyone. And we don't have, you know, the greed for the kingdom. And they immediately left from that place. Now the thief was happy because he was thinking, at least, you know, I'll be the person who will marry the king's daughter. He was thinking like that. Now, you know, king started pleading to the, you know, the brahmacharis. And he told, please marry with my daughter, you know. They told, no, we are the brahmachari, we have taken the vow to remain the brahmachari. And they also left. Now there were only few people, some few brahmanas. And king asked them, please marry with my daughter. They told, we are already married. We don't need any, you know, one more girl in our life, one more wife in our life. We are satisfied in chanting Krishna's glory and we don't need the kingdom. What the use of kingdom? We are already satisfied. And they also left. Now the thief, he was there alone. King came to him. My dear Brahmana, he thought he is a Brahmana. He thought he is a sannyasi. My dear sannyasi, please marry with my daughter. And he told to the king, my dear king, I am not the sannyasi. Nor I am the Brahmana, I am the thief. I had come here with the intention to loot the people, to steal their money, to steal your money. But in their association, I could realize that this kingdom, the women are nothing in front of what they are relishing in their life. By seeing their, you know, behavior, by seeing their approach, by seeing their desires, I could understand that there is something better in the life which is more than kingdom and, you know, the opposite sex. I also have decided to join them. Thank you. And then he left. So this is the story that how the transformation can come in the heart just by being in a few moments of association with the devotees of the Lord. It is explained in the Srimad Bhagavatam that Satam Prasangat Mama Virya Samvido Bhavant Ritkarana Rasayana Kata Tad Joshanat Ashwapavarga Vartmani Shraddha Ratir Bhakti Anukramishati. So in this verse, Maharshi Kapil explains to his mother Devahuti the advantages, the benefits of the association with the devotees. He tells that when the materialistic people comes in the association of the devotees and he hears the glories of Krishna, Lord Vishnu, then his heart gets purified of all the nonsense tendencies and his path for the liberation gets opened. His path for the liberation starts. And now what happened? Then attraction for the Supreme Personality of the for the Godhead increases in his heart and his devotional service starts. So this is the benefit of the association. We see in the scripture there are so many incidences we find that just by little association, one comes in the association of devotees and he gets purified, he gets transformed, his life gets changed. For example, Valmiki, then we have the Mrugari and so many incidences, you know. That's why in Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita says that sadhu sangha, sadhu sangha, sarva shastra koi lava matra sadhu sangha, sarva siddhi hoi. Just by moments of association with the devotees of the Lord, our whole life can be transformed. You know, when we come in the association of devotees, our aspirations are changed, our desires are changed, and our intentions are changed, and we become a devotee of Krishna. And that's why, you know, we always should seek the association of devotees, because that association will lead to higher happiness, the eternal bliss. Hare Krishna.